deciphering the meaning of the first cat word. When I was in high school in 1966, I started doing yoga. Meditation too is part of yoga practice. I also tried to meditate, but I was not successful. At the time, I interpreted the tutorial so that enough if I calm down and my internal dialogue will stop on its own. But internal dialogue is a very persistent system. It will not stop its own. Even then, I ask myself how speech can affect our level of consciousness so effectively. In 1984, at the artist colony, I met Takumi Matsumoto. He lived in a Buddhist monastery for 3 years before going on sculpture. He recounted how the monks taught him to meditate. He stressed that to stop the internal dialogue, everyone needs to create a key for themselves. I logically conclude that if speech fixes our consciousness, then during evolution, speech and consciousness had to develop simultaneously. So, each animal species must have its spoken language. This conclusion prepared me to pay attention to the vocal manifestation of the animals as meaningful speech. The speech of the cats came to the center of my attention completely by accident. In 1997, my parents brought 2 little cats home. The little female often followed me and mewed me. Liked it to me or not, I had to pay attention to her. Due to the persistent mewing, it was given to her the name Nyatsi. Uncle Yanni, the local fisherman, brought fish to us. When he appeared at the gate, Nyatsi rushed toward to him and loudly, understandably, mewed, "Murra, murra, murra." Based on my suspicion that animal species have their language, I conclude "murra" could be the name for fish in the language of cats. The idea came up right away. I will do a check. I did put the remaining small fishes in the fridge. The next day I didn't take the fish out of the fridge. I just stood in front of the kitchen and shouted, "Murra, murra, murra." Nyatsi flew from the garden like a rifle bullet. He danced around me and mewed, "Murra, murra, murra." The meaning of the first cat word was thus deciphered. Obviously, the "murra" means fish. My significant discovery was too that when I say the cat word in my voice, Nyatsi understands. So, cats not only have good hearing, but are also intelligent. My cat language dictionary has grown slowly but surely. Nyatsi's offspring become even more eloquent than their mother. My cats realize that my hearing is weaker than theirs. They help me, spoke to me slowly and louder.